In this video, I am trying to explain how arrays are declared or how arrays are created, how to access the elements from the array, and what are the different methods available in JavaScript regarding the arrays. So, there are two ways we can create array in JavaScript. One is by using a new keyword. The second one is usually the traditional way. Here, you can see the example that shows the array declaration, that is var means variable array name is equal to square bracket 1 by 1 items. Also you can use the JavaScript keyword new to create the array. Here the same cars are created by using new array. Here we are not using square bracket, we are using symbol brackets to create the array. Then how to access the array elements? Just like you see, we use index number to access array elements. That is, car of 0 means SAP, car of 1 Volvo, car of 2 BMW. Here the indexing always starts from 0, just like C programming language. Then the full array can be, the advantage of here in JavaScript is that the full array can be accessed by referring to the array name. Here you can see a JavaScript code inside an HTML page using script tag, inside the script tag. Okay, here variable cars is defined, and using the function document.getElementId of demo. Demo is the ID name of paragraph tag. Dot inner HTML is equal to car means here the cars is the full array name. So the SAP, Volvo and BMW is printed. This is the result you can see in the right side. In the left side, you can write the program. You can see the program. Save this program as .html and open this in a browser. You can see this result of this program. That in the right side, you can see the result. This result you can see in your browser. Okay. Next, we can go to the type of operator. What is the type of operator in objects? In arrays are, arrays are objects in the case of JavaScript. Here, you can see a simple program using array. Here, person is an array with the value John Doe and 46. When you are using document.write function, person of 1 means the Doe will be printed. If you are using person of 0, then John will be printed. Here, arrays are viewed as objects. When we apply type of operator in array, you can see the object is returned, that its type is object type. So, array in JavaScript is viewed as objects. Okay. Next, what are the properties that are available in JavaScript regarding the arrays? Here, you can get the length of an array using an inbuilt function in case of JavaScript by using .length. That is, here, cars.length means it returns the number of elements in cars array. Okay. Then cars.sort means the sort method sorts the array. Clear? There is another method available is toString. Array name.toString converts the array to a string type. Here, you can see a JavaScript program, an example program that converts the array to toString and print the result using document.write. Okay, here in the script tag you can see fruits is an array with values banana, orange, apple and mango. Then we have to print it screen by using document.write fruits.toString method. This is the result you get. The toString method, the advantage of toString method is that it returns array as a comma separated string. It returns array as a comma separated string. You remember this. Okay. Next you can go to how to add array elements. There is a method called push, similar to the push and pop operation that you already studied in data structures. Here variable fruits. Here fruits is defined as banana, orange, apple and mango. Fruits.pushLemon means lemon is added to this fruits. Okay. You can remove the last element using pop operation using fruits.pop operation. There is another method called join method. It join all array elements to string. Here is an example that shows the join method. Here, the peculiarity of join method is that you can use the separator between the array elements in the case of join. Here, fruits is defined as banana, orange, apple, mango. So, fruits array is defined. Before printing, here we use join method, and join method here we use star operator to separate this. Here, banana, star, orange, star, apple, star, mango, you can see in the result. This is in the left side you can see the program, in the right side you can see the output of the program. Please do the program using, type the program using notepad, save it as .html, open the same in browser, you can see the result seen in the right side. Okay, the difference between the join and two string is that two string just converts an array to a string, but it must be separated by comma. Okay, but we can use, in the case of join method, join also creates a string, but the difference is that we can use any type of separator in between the elements. Okay, you can use comma or star or hyphen or colon, anyone you can use. The next is the shift method. It removes the first array element and shift all the other elements to the lower index. This is an example that shows here variable fruits is equal to banana, orange, apple. Fruits dot shift means banana will be removed and the array will start from orange, apple and mango. Unshift method is used to add a new element to an array at the beginning. Okay. Delete element can be used to delete the elements in an array. Here, variable fruits is equal to banana, orange, apple, mango. Delete fruits of 0 means banana will be removed. So, the difference between shift and delete is that shift removes the first array element. But the delete method can be used to delete any element, any location, element from any location. Okay. Then, unshift method is used to add new element, new items to an array. Okay. Splice method, sorry, unshift method is used to add a new element to an array, but it adds a new element to a beginning. Then there is another method that can be used to add new element to an array by using a splice method. Here you can see an example that use a splice method. Here array is defined, where fruits array is defined as banana, orange, apple and mango. We have to insert or add new items to an array. Here there are two values. You can see what are the two parameters. The first parameter two defines where new elements should be added. That is, second position you add new elements. The second parameter defines how many elements should be added. How many elements should be added. So, this is the second example, the splice method. Fruits dot slice means lemon and kiwi will be inserted or added to the new items. Okay. Please use these methods in your program. There is another method called concat method. It creates a new array by merging existing or concatenating existing arrays. Here, girls and boys are the two arrays. These are concatenated and be stored in my children. Okay. This is the concat method. You can concatenate two arrays or merge two arrays to create new array. To create a new array, you can concatenate three arrays by separate. For example, I have three arrays, my girls, my boys, my toys. You can concatenate three arrays together by using my girls dot concat my boys comma my toys. So the three arrays will be concatenated. My girls, my boys, my toys, all the three are concatenated together and will be stored in my children. So next is slice method. The slice method, the peculiarity is that it creates a new array. Okay. It does not remove any elements from the source array. The previous methods will remove some elements from the array. Here, a new array will be created and the slice result will be stored in that array. For example, banana, orange, lemon, apple, mango is a fruit array. Fruit.slice3 means the three elements will be removed, not removed from the fruits. Here a new array, citrus array, will be created, and you can see apple and mango in this citrus array. Okay, the three will be removed from the starting position. It slices out three array elements. Next, slice method can take two arguments like slice 1, 3. 1 is the position, 3 means the number of elements to be removed. From what, how many elements to be sliced? Sort method. The next is the sort method. The sort method, the peculiarity of sort method is it sort an array alphabetically. This function cannot be used for sorting numbers. For example, variable fruits is equal to banana, orange, apple and mango. Fruit.sort means it will sort the array using alphabetical order. So the result will be apple, banana, mango and orange. There is also a method called a reverse method. It reverses the elements in an array. So the next video I will explain about the string. Okay.